Today's video is brought to you by You Need a Budget and My Chapped Upper Lip. Today we're going to be learning how to create a budget template. Cue intro sequence. First order of business, we need a more exciting intro sequence. And the rest order of business. Our mantra for all YNAB users is only budget the money you have. Only budget the money you have. Only budget the money you have. And this is the point where a lot of people stop and say, but how do I do that when the money I have is less than what I owe? Introducing the budget template. This is an incredible method if you're someone who makes variable income or someone who gets paid twice a month. So today I'm going to show you how to make your very own budget template, and to do so I'm going to start a brand new one. So I took to the internet and discovered the average American US household income after taxes is a monthly take-home amount of $3,261 a month. So we're just gonna base our budget off of these numbers. Now let's pretend that I'm someone who only gets paid twice a month on the 1st and the 15th. We're gonna start here with our super real budget. Now I currently don't have any accounts linked, so let me just make one. If I'm someone who gets paid twice a month and my monthly take-home amount is $3,261, then that means my bi-monthly paycheck is $1,630.50. Never leave out the change. So first, I'm gonna start by making this a real budget. So let me go through and fill out all the categories. I like to call this home improvement because of Tim Allen. I don't have an auto loan, delete. I'm gonna add dog. What food item symbolically represents all of groceries? A banana, corn, some large shoes to fill corn. I'm gonna do carrot. My nephew told me the other day he can see in the dark because he eats carrots. Okay, so now we have all of our categories listed and beautified. Now we're gonna go through and we're gonna add a goal for every single category. So first up, we have rent. A typical one bedroom here might be about $800. So I'm gonna come down here and I'm going to click create rent goal. Now, if my rent is $800, I'm gonna make that a monthly goal. So we've set the goal. You can see here, it's telling us we need $800 more to meet our goal. And down here, we have this whole tracking system. Very cool, very mathematical, very lovely. My water bill seems to be about $70 a month. Phone is about $30 a month. And I also wanted to clarify that I am crafting a budget for a single person in the Midwest. So if you're looking at my totals and are like, what? You may have noticed there is a sweeping variety of goal types. Two of the goal types are more geared towards spending, while the other two are more geared towards savings. So right now we're going to talk about the monthly goal type. And this one's pretty straightforward. If there is a certain amount of money you need every single month for a category, like for instance, my internet bill is $52 every single month, I'm going to select the monthly goal, set the amount for $52, and every month it's going to prompt me to put in $52 every single month. Next, what we're gonna do is go through our entire budget, and any category that has a due date, we're gonna go ahead and add that due date in next to it. For instance, my rent, go figure, is always due on the 1st of the month. Now for me, I also like to make it really obvious how much money needs to go in each category, so I also add how much money is due and how often. That's just me. You don't have to add in the total, but I think it helps. It gives a better, broader view of my money. Now for things like groceries, that does not have a due date, obviously, but I still like to put the amount I'm gonna wanna spend every month. For me, as a single person, I spend $200 a month on groceries. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna drag and drop these all into the correct chronological order. So now all of our immediate obligations are listed in order based on when they're due and how much they cost. Organizing all your bills and expenses by due date is super handy for prioritizing, making sure you have the right money in the right place at the right time. So now I'm just gonna go through my budget, and for all the expenses I have that don't have due dates, I'm gonna add that desired total to each line. So I spend a lot on my dog, you guys. She eats nice food and we do doggy daycare, so. Now, if any of you guys have a category that is like kryptonite for you, you overspend every month, my money. That is clothing for me. Stereotypical as it might be for a female, I'm sorry. I love shoes. So I'm working my way down my budget and I've come to the quality of life goals section, which by the way, I would totally retitle all these to make them something fun. Actually, I'm gonna do that right now. I named this next category group, we're gonna talk about the big tickets because these are the things that only happen a couple times a year. But here at YNAB, we are just the biggest believers in saving and preparing for those later down the road things now so that we don't have to borrow money for them later. In this category, I have summer camp for my fictitious kids, vacation, and Christmas 2020. My favorite category because it's so satisfying to get to Christmas and just, all right, what does everybody want for Christmas? Now, as you probably already guessed, we're not gonna use the monthly goal type for these expenses. We actually have two options. We can use the by date goal or the target balance goal. The by date goal assumes that you'll still be spending out of that category while trying to fund the goal, and your progress won't be set back at all. Let me show you what I mean in my Christmas category. So for Christmas, I set a goal to save $600 by December of 2020. Now you can see I'm about two-thirds of the way funded to my Christmas goal. Say it's September and I run across the perfect Christmas gift for my brother. Now, am I gonna wait until my Christmas category is fully funded in December to buy that gift for him? No, I just wanna save $600 for Christmas. Let's go ahead and add in that transaction. Something from the Star Wars store. That's probably a real place. When we come back to our Christmas category, you can see I budgeted $200. I already spent $75, but look, if you went ahead and bought that gift out of your Christmas category now, it wouldn't set back your progress because you wanted to save $600 for Christmas and that purchase was for Christmas. So it's totally okay and doesn't set you back at all if you wanna take money out of that category. Or you wanna save a specific amount of money by a specific date, but any spending of this money any earlier than that date would be a total no-no. That's when you wanna choose the target balance goal type. An example would be, say you and an old friend from college are going on a road trip. You need to save $500 by September and you're 50% of the way to funding your trip. However, your car breaks down, you gotta roll with the punches, you end up taking some money out of your road trip category. You were at 50%, but now since you took money out of it, it bumped you all the way back to 25%. The target balance goal type will not let you get away with spending money early. It's gonna notice and say, excuse me, where'd that money go? Can you put that back, please? Whew, all right, friends. So now we have our budget template. Whew. What is so cool about this is your budget is way more automated now than it ever was before, and you have a full picture of all of your expenses for the whole year. Yes. Now let's talk colors real quickly, because now that you've added all these goals, you may have noticed a lot more color in your budget than before. Now, if you have a category where you haven't set a goal for it and there's no money in it, it's just gonna be gray. As soon as I take this and make it a goal, $800 every month, now we have our yellow bubble here. It's gonna tell you how far you are to funding that goal in full. Now let's say I'm just gonna fund rent halfway for the month. I'm gonna put $400 in my rent category. Now you can see that my pie chart is halfway full because I'm halfway there. Thanks, pie chart. You'll notice that the bubble is still yellow because yellow means incomplete. Unlike traffic where yellow means slow down, this means keep going, which to some of us actually is what a yellow light means. Now let's say for kicks and giggles, I'm just gonna fund my rent in full right now. So if I budget $800 for this, boom. We went from yellow to green because this category is fully funded and it even comes with the satisfying check mark. But remember why we set up the budget template? It was because we owed more money than we currently had. So we're gonna take every expense we have one step at a time. Now remember, with YNAB, we will only ever budget with the true money we have in our bank accounts right now. Doesn't matter if you're getting paid tomorrow, a week from now, don't even think about that money because you don't have it yet. But here's the problem. I was only able to fund 10 of my 26 categories before I ran into that awful red underfunded warning. So let's backtrack. Undo, 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 undo. Currently we have $1,630.50 to get us through the next 2 weeks. So now it's time to harness the power that is the budget template. I get paid again on the 15th, so what I'm gonna do is look for all the expenses I need to fund before the 15th. So for the sake of this demonstration, let's say today is February 1st. I already paid my February rent at the end of January, so this rent that we're budgeting for is actually for March. So if I were to put $800 in my rent category and fully fund it, well, then I only have $830 left to make it through the next 2 weeks. I might be able to do that, but I don't need $800 right now for rent, but I do need to make sure I can eat this week and get places in my car. So I'm just gonna fund rent halfway. $400 now, and I'll put in $400 more later when I get my next paycheck on the 15th. Out of my expenses that have due dates, that looks like it's gonna be the gas, my phone bill, water, and electric. These are all the expenses I need to make sure that I can pay in full right now. Now that these are all selected, go ahead and slide on over to these quick budgeting tools and you'll see this handy dandy underfunded button. It tells us that we would need $275 in order to fully fund those four bills that we have coming up. So I'm gonna click it. There she goes. I clicked it and hey, looky here. All of these categories are now fully funded. I could go ahead and fund the rest of my upcoming bills, but I think that's kind of silly because I have a lot of life to live until then. So I'm gonna go ahead and budget halfway to some of these goals. For instance, I budget $200 a month for my dog every month. She's kind of bougie. She definitely goes to daycare. So I'm gonna go ahead and only fund half of her needs right now. I'm gonna put in $50 to auto maintenance. I'm gonna budget halfway to medical, clothing. I mean, I'm just gonna fund that all the way because you never know when you're gonna spend that. Halfway to gifts, halfway to giving. Now my summer camp category says I need $57.15 every month to be on track with that. I'm just gonna fund that in full right now. I'm gonna do the full total for the month. As you can see, I didn't quite make it all the way through my budget funding things halfway before I ran out of money. I over budgeted by $13. So what I'm gonna do, I'm trying to cut back on coffee. So I'm going to remove that $13.70 from my coffee category. So now I only have $6.30 in my coffee category for the next 2 weeks, but I just don't need the caffeine this month, or so we will find out. So what's awesome is I know I'm gonna make it through the next 2 weeks just fine. I have totally enough money for groceries, for my dog, to get gas. All my bills that I need to pay will be paid, no problem. So now we're gonna jump 2 weeks ahead in the future. I'm gonna go ahead and add a transaction as if I got paid. Payment guy. So now it's February 15th, I got my second paycheck for the month and I have another $1,630.50. So what's cool is since we set up this whole template with all these goals that knows how much we need in every category for every month, we don't have to do the dirty work anymore. We don't have to go into each column and divide everything by two and manually type in the amount. Oh no, no time for that. You can come up to this top little square guy. What's the like technical term for that? Square guy, that's all I can come up with. So we're gonna click this little square guy. He's gonna highlight all of our categories that we've ever had. And looky here, if we go to the underfunded category, we actually only need $1,423.70 to fund the rest of our life for the month the entire way. And now I just get to take this guy, this one little, press the button, and look, my whole budget just got funded for the month. Hallelujah. That was so easy. So now my rent is fully funded. I'm gonna be able to pay my renter's insurance, internet, subscriptions, everything. Easy peasy. If the caffeine withdrawal got too strong, now I have money again to go get coffee. Honestly, that was way too easy. What this template does is really helps you keep from overspending. It helps you see what priorities are number one, because those due dates are right in front of you. You know exactly how much you will owe and exactly on what date you will owe it. So let's move into the next month. It's March 1st and we just got our paycheck again. We can distribute this money however we need to. So let's say this week I am going on a trip and I can't take my dog with me. I'm gonna need to board her while I'm gone. I can focus more money toward my dog these 2 weeks and less money toward my dog the next 2 weeks when I get paid again. With the budget template, you'll always see how far your goals have been funded so far, and therefore, how much further you have to go. And let's get real, it's just kind of fun. You know you're a budgeter when you love payday. Not because of the money, but because you get to update your budget. I hope you guys have a total blast setting up your budget template and finally getting ahead of your money. If you ever have any questions, we have tons of resources linked below, and always feel free to reach out to us. We love talking about budgeting. Well, that about wraps things up. So if you guys don't mind, we gotta go. Our show's on at 7. See you next time. Come on, Banksy. You need to eat every single month. Your gas always needs cars. I mean, today we're gonna learn how to make a budget template. Now there's a yellow bubble and there's also this little, what is this really? I'll tell you what it is, it's a piece of pie. Well, it's a pie like minus a piece, or is that a piece? It's a graph, it's a pie chart graph. It's math.